month ago, no one was calling the Flyers Destiny's Darlings or the team that wouldn't be denied. But hockey seasons can be made or broken in the springtime. And this year's Flyers have spent the last month establishing a resilient identity. A miraculous season-ending playoff-clinching victory can provide a springboard for that. As can an impressive ouster of a longtime nemesis. But adversity has chased these Flyers all season. Important pieces of their puzzle have been continually taken away. They survived, but against the Bruins, the Flyers faced their most daunting adversity yet. Three tight games yielded nothing but frustration and a 3-0 series deficit. But at their darkest hour, their newfound identity served them well. A dramatic elimination-avoiding win in Game 4 gave way to a momentum-producing dominant victory in Game 5. Warriors continued to fall. Others kept stepping in. A captain took charge. And playoff stalwarts excelled on the postseason stage once again. And now they stand on the verge of something truly special. A banged-up group that shrugs off misfortune and thrives when they absolutely must is one win away from doing something only two NHL teams have ever done. All Game 7s are special. Tonight's could be momentous. Finality of Game 7 in sport. Nothing quite like it. The fans feel it here in Boston, and the players for sure feel it as well. And for the Flyers, a chance to make some history tonight. They climb back from a 0-3 hole in this series. Now they try to finish it off. It's Game 7 of the Eastern Conference semifinal series between the Flyers and Bruins here from the TD Garden in Boston. And a pleasant good evening. Welcome to Flyers playoff hockey here on Comcast Sports. That along with Bill Clement, I'm Jim Jackson. Steve Coates will join us here in just a moment. Well, Bill, whether it's kismet or destiny or what have you, the Flyers are here in Game 7. No one thought they'd be here, but here they are. But they still have one more win to climb the hill.
Well, there's nothing like a Game 7, but understand something. One of these teams, and it's the Flyers, really is happy to be here in a Game 7. The other team, the Boston Bruins, didn't want to be here at all. So we'll see how that pans out. In a Game 7, you hope you can get something from your role players, but more than that, you hope that your thoroughbreds can make it around that track one more time. Mike Richards and Danny Briere have been the heart of the Flyers offense, and as the games have gotten more important, they have ratcheted up their play. We'll see if they've got one more notch. On the blue line, Chris Pronger, Kimmo Timonen, important on both sides of the puck. Power play has hit in both of the last two games. Pronger and Timonen a part of that, but should the Flyers get the lead in this game, the presence of Pronger and Timonen on the blue line will be priceless.
So forwards, defense, yes, important, but we can't forget about the goaltenders. Steve, Coach Tuukka Rask, Michael Layton, both playing their first ever Game 7s at this level.
It's absolutely unbelievable when you think of Brian Brochet was a big reason why the Philadelphia Flyers got this far, but in comes Michael Layton in only his second start in his career in the playoffs, and he's got an absolutely unbelievable save percentage of .978. How about that one? He has been absolutely spectacular for the Philadelphia Flyers, but as has Tuukka Rask for the Boston Bruins, who took the job away from Tim Thomas, who won the Vezina Trophy last year. Snap on those seatbelts, everybody. Coming up, it's the Philadelphia Flyers and the Boston Bruins.
Tonight's Flyers-Bruins Game 7 is brought to you by your local Tri-State Toyota dealers. Go Flyers, go Toyota. Toyota moving forward. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. By Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. And by Hyundai. Think Hyundai, but act now for special lease deals at your Hyundai dealer. Flyers' last Game 7 experience was a pleasant one. 2008 in Washington against the Capitals, Joffrey Lupul stepped into the role of Game 7 overtime hero. The Flyers eliminated the Caps and produced one of their most memorable moments. Face-off for this Game 7 after these messages. Tonight's first period on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by Pepsi Max. Maximum taste, maximum energy, zero calories. and by VWLocal.com. Go to VWLocal.com or your area Volkswagen dealer to learn more about great deals on all their new vehicles. And the TD Garden here in Boston is rocking. Yes, lots of noise being made as these fans hope their Bruins can avoid making history. But noise being made back in Philadelphia. Viewing party at the Wachovia Center and a special edition of God Bless America as well. At the Wachovia Center. Lots of support for the Flyers back in Philadelphia. We give a shout out to all the fans in Philly and here at Boston. Black and gold, they try to support their Bruins. 14th game seven in Flyers history, about to get underway.
And our Kia Motors starting goaltenders for the Boston Bruins, Tuukka Rask. That hasn't changed. That score in game six could have been way lopsided in the Flyers' favor without Rask. And Michael Layton, who came on in relief in this building for Brian Boucher in game five, got his first career playoff start and first career playoff win in game six. Starts for the Flyers here in seven.
Who would have believed we'd be here for game seven? Flyers falling behind 3-0 in this series. They've won three straight. First time in 35 years a team has even made it to a game seven from that situation. Now they try to finish the deal. Underway, the Flyers wearing their road whites. No black uniforms for the Bruins as Mike Richards gets to the puck and moves up. Richards, Carcillo, and Gagne getting things started for the Flyers. Kulichuk moves Carcillo to the wall to puck up the wall. Tiivanen got a piece of it, gathers it now, and turns it deeper into the corner. Donnie Boychuk after it. And now it's controlled by Gagne. Gagne holding, centering. Fanning on the shot was Carcillo. And the Bruins will move back. And Mark Recchi, the former Flyer, will chip it in and chase. Steven gets in his way. Coburn back to get the puck. Steven Walkham and Kelly Sutherland are your referees in this game. Greg Dvorsky, Pierre Rasico handle the line.
See both teams trying to get the puck in deep and establish a forecheck. The Flyers did on their first rush. They did on their second rush as well.
Aaron Asham after the puck deep in Boston ice. And combinations for the Flyers at the top of your screen as Asham was dumped in the corner. Now Weidman ahead. Adepaye chopping that puck deeper into the Philadelphia zone. Carl after it, checked by Sobotka. Shot and a save made by Leighton down low. Rebound and that stuffed wide. Bruins getting some chances here as Paye off the wall with his check, but the Flyers unable to find the puck. Finally, it's discovered by Asham, and he'll skate it up. Aaron Asham. James Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk around behind for Asham. He had Van Riemsdyk in front, but the puck hit the side of the net. Boston Lion combinations now appearing at the top of your screen. Some changes there from Claude Julien. Blake Wheeler now playing on one of the top lines. There's Kimo teaming in the middle to Briera. Briera ahead. Billy Lane looking for it. Tipped away by Chara. Nato Chara looking for his first ever win in a game 7. 0-4. He is illustrious career. As the Bruins move the puck in. Miroslav Shatan holding back out. Shot Boychuk blocked. Flyers had 30 blocks in game 6. Get one early in this one. And teaming into the puck. Billy Leno, and he'll move up just over 2 minutes in. Glad you could join us. Comcast Sportsnet and at the Wachovia Center. As the Flyers and Bruins tangle in their first ever game 7 against one another. Big hit by Andreas Nodal in the corner. And he's able to get the puck. He pumps it deeper into the Boston zone. Boychuk takes a hit from Powell. He's the hit leader in this series. Both teams are bouncing around, and finally the Bruins get to it. Moved ahead, Steve Bégin. Cross ice pass for Sean Thornton. Turning is Ryan Parrott. He'll get to it. Ridden to the boards with good support from Blair Betts. Betts cleared it to the line, but not out. Andrew Ferentz is there. Back along for Bégin. Now Trent Whitfield. He's given a rough ride by Parrott. Sean Thornton's in after it. Whitfield fights the check off. Moves up the wall with it. Betts is right there. Support again.
Play. What a play by Blair Betts. Great to see him in the lineup. You know that he's playing nicked up and dinged up after coming back in game 6 and not playing in the third period, but he's out there and doing what he can.
And he's not alone in that regard. This is a banged up team. Of course, the Bruins are banged up as well. You don't get this far in the playoffs without incurring injuries. Asham with a shot that sails high and wide. Out to Matt Carl, sent one toward the net. Chara is right there. The outlets. And it rolls to Carl at the red line, and he'll flutter it back into the Bruins zone. We've played almost 3.5 minutes, still waiting for the first shot on goal. Couple of goaltenders. I thought Leighton got one of those ones in that scramble, but apparently it was blocked in front of him. So both goalies waiting for their first shot. As nervous as they might be in a game 7 to begin with, now they're waiting to see the rubber. There's Giroux moving up. And he'll fire that save made by Rask.
But Rask regurged that rebound straight out. So if I'm on the bench noticing that, keep shooting.
Lots of hits for the Bruins early. The Ryder couldn't handle that pass. Weidman with a blast, and it went through heavy traffic wide. The Leighton never saw it. And now Gagne will clear off his stick to Richards. Mike Richards moving up 2-on-2. Now getting help as Coburn joins. Richards with a pass to Gagne for the shot. Block, rebound, jab wide. Gagne gets to it. Simone Gagne around behind. Fires high and wide. Passes to Richards for Timonen. Knocks it down with a glove and then plays it with a stick to Richards. Richards in front hoping for Gagne, broken up by Ryder. Bruins try to clear and they do all the way down. This will be icing and we'll get a whistle. How about that? As back the touch-up is Braden Coburn. And there they are, the orange, the sea of orange at the Wachovia Center. Give yourself a hand. That's impressive.
Unbelievable. Party on. Party on.
Now they see themselves. Great to have the support. I'm sure the Flyers happy for that support. They've got some people here as well. There are some orange jerseys interspersed among the black and gold here at TD Garden.
Michael Leighton pointed something out along the boards with the ice, and the officials are looking at that down behind Michael Leighton.
So, Coatsy, why don't you tell us about your keys to the game?
Well, first of all, Michael Leighton's got to come up big for the Philadelphia Flyers, just a second start in the playoffs. And then take a look at the way that the Flyers have done a great job of protecting that area in front of Leighton. That's got to continue in this hockey game. And the last one, who handles the pressure best on both these teams?
Yeah, great keys, Coatsy. And part of handling the pressure is controlling your adrenaline and controlling it the day of the game. The Flyers this morning talked about not getting to the rink tonight completely exhausted. You have to be able to control your emotions and your adrenaline and save some for the game.
There are the virtuous scratches, same lineups for the two clubs. There was some debate as to whether that would be the case for the Flyers because of their injuries, but everybody on board that won in game 6, Peter Laviolette, wants his team to
yes, play smart, Bill, but he doesn't want them to be too careful.
Well, he doesn't want them to be afraid of making a mistake, and I agree 100%. If you play afraid to make mistakes, that's when you will make them.
Well, Julian, trying to keep his team together as they try to avoid having a 3-0 series lead. And third team to do that. First, it's 1975. Race for the puck in the Boston zone, and it's tipped away to the corner. But the Flyers get it to Quagg. His shot blocked by Lucic. Lucic will move up. Lucic in across the line. Tries to go wide on Quagg. Centered it. Blocked away by Carl. He got right in Chatan's kitchen there to keep it away from him. And now it's Lucic behind the net. Quagg trying to get to him. Lucic out in the slot. Shot Savard. Glance wide. Pronger tips. Hartnell chops at it, but it's tipped by Savard back into the Philadelphia zone. Pronger calmly. Oh, Hartnell missed it. It goes to Hunley for the shot. Stick save, Layton. Not to say great play by Pronger, and it was, but Scott Hartnell just missed the puck, and that led to that last chance. And now Hartnell gets his stick up in the face of Matt Hunwick, and he'll go. First penalty of the game belongs to Philadelphia as Hartnell will go to the sin bin, and the Bruins get a power play.
Boy, what an interesting shift for Scott Hartnell. He started the shift by making a real good play in the offensive zone, then by blowing it in the defensive zone, and then trying to swat the puck out of midair and hitting Hunwick in the face.
Well, Hunwick's not the biggest guy in the world, so that makes it even easier for him to be able to get that stick right to the head. But Scotty Hartnell's just trying to lock that puck out of the air, and in his aggressiveness to do the right thing, ends up with a penalty.
So the Bruins to the power play. And here's Chara with the bomb. Pad save, Layton. Rebound, Ryder shot, he scores. The all-important first goal belongs to Boston. A power play tally. Bruins 1, Flyers no score.
Boy, that didn't take long. And Michael Layton made an outstanding save. Blair Betts doing his best with a banged-up wing on the faceoff. That's the save that Michael Layton made, and I'll give Michael Ryder a ton of credit. We talk a lot about getting the loose pucks and puck retrieval. Michael Ryder of the Boston Bruins got to that puck real quick.
Not too often that Michael Layton lets a rebound out quite as hard as that came back out. Ryder had the opportunity, and you hit it right there, Billy, where he just turned around, wheeled it, and let it go immediately. Layton wasn't set yet on that rebound.
So the Bruins get their fourth power play goal of this series. They have the first goal. All-time numbers good. And the numbers for teams that score first in game sevens, very strong. 72% of them win. So the Flyers once again facing some adversity. What's new? Sobotka. Not as far as Coburn. Coburn ahead to James Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk did not get in across the line before Giroux, and so offside is called. Flyers had numbers. That's a missed opportunity. Michael Ryder with a power play tally has the Bruins on top early in Beantown. One nothing Bruins. One thing these teams and their fans can agree on, they want to play Montreal on Sunday. And there is the number we were talking about, 72%, including all three in this version of the playoffs. Means the score first have gone on to win.
When,
so,
when I see that number, as long as it's not 100, I'm okay.
Yeah, that means what? 28% have come
three
from behind
of,
to win.
Three out of four win. Yeah. I mean, it's not staggering.
Well, and the first three this year have won. So actually, the Flyers are due to be the first team of this year's playoffs to come from behind. We'll see if they can do that as Layton covers up. Shots 5-1 Boston early.
5 minutes, 27 seconds.
Simone Gagné battling through the broken toe. Off the draw, here is Chara with a wrist shot blocked by Mike Richards. Chara and Hunwick, by the way, got assists on the Ryder goal, 5:27. Johnny Boychuk ahead. Wheeler redirects into the Philadelphia zone, teaming in his backcourt. Here comes Reiki, crashing into him and knocking him down. Puck moving slow in the Flyers zone right there, and that's allowing the Bruins to really get in after him. Recky after Coburn. And the Flyers come away with a puck, but then Richards misfiring on the pass. It will not be icing.
Yeah, the Bruins, you can tell, are trying to take advantage of that 2 or 3 minutes of huge adrenaline rush that you get after your team scores. It's a real important couple of minutes here for the Flyers.
Hartnell turns it over at the line. Savard looking for the return feed. Nearly got it. It twists on through his Pronger cover, Lucic. There after the puck in the corner. Pronger and Lucic battle. It's batted, but controlled by Boston. Here's Savard twisting in the corner. Back out to Stewart. Rolling around behind for Lucic, dropping it on. Chetan over skates. Milano's back to pick it up, but he's checked. The puck bounces free. Carl now to it. And he'll move it ahead for Briere, but he's stationary in center. Does play it ahead. Carl joining the rush. Numbers for Philadelphia, but his pass is blocked by Lucic and batted to the corner. Leno tries to center. Went off of Rask. Back out. Krejcik shot. Safe. Rebound. Leno sent it back out in front. Loose puck. They jam for it. And Rask makes the save. Krejcik in the backhand. Knocked down by Weidman. Weidman couldn't find the puck in his skates. He's then checked. The helmet comes off. And there's the penalty. Leno then taken down. They could call another one. But the first penalty is on Philadelphia.
It's on Danny Briere.
Lucic then takes a tumble.
Boy, I'll tell you what, that could have very well been even up right there. But it looks like it's just going to be Danny Briere for knocking the helmet off of Weidman. But Weidman absolutely tripped up Leno after the play. But before that, some great chances for the Philadelphia Flyers. And what we talk about, you hear us talk about east-west, watch Rask. Okay, he's ready for the puck. Now the puck goes to the right, comes back to the left. That's east-west. That's the way you score on this guy. Oh, yeah, he's pretty good going pipe to pipe. But right there, you see the penalty. Weidman just turns and said, hey, he knocked my helmet off.
Well, the Flyers are in a hole right now. This is a must-kill.
They're gone. And the Bruins go right to work. There's a Hunwick shot. Metz was there, and they couldn't get it through. Even Rask says man up. There's Ryan digging the puck loose, though. The Bruins win the battle. Back to Chara. Chara for Recchi. Recchi back for Chara. He'll blast, and that, I think, might have hit Ryder. Perhaps a little stronger blocking. It didn't get through. Now Chara has it again. Across ice, Hunwick. Back to Chara, one-timer, didn't get all of it. Tiedemann scoops it out of harm's way, and Powell throws it the rest of the way. The numbers of these units throughout the playoffs. Powell able to clear here in this series. The Bruins now 4-for-21 with a man advantage. In general, the Flyers have done a good job with the penalty kill. Good work there by Giroux, just making the Bruins take time to emerge from their own zone halfway through the power play.
Not only did Giroux execute a really good forecheck, but then was back in position to stall the Bruins again.
And now he gets his stick on the puck in the neutral zone. They recaptured by Boston. Krejcik to Weidman. Weidman in across the Philadelphia zone. Wide on Carl. Centered it. They score. Lucic going hard to the net. And the Bruins power play doing the damage early. 2-0 Boston.
Well, how often do we talk about paying a price for penalties that you really didn't have to take? This is the case for the Flyers on the first two. Milan Lucic came in the back door and nobody saw him over the shoulder. Claude Giroux was back, but not back in time.
That's a big body to be able to cover, but Weidman does a great job. He looks up, he's got his head up, and Lucic outside the pipe. That's the key. He's not inside the net, so that gives him all that much more net to work with because Leighton's still on the other side. But that's a great play by Lucic to get to the net.
Now, he has been arguably the best player for the Bruins in this series.
Certainly the most consistent.
Fourth goal of the series. So now the task much tougher for the Flyers, down two. The good news, lots of time. They have to get their bearings, though. Here's Bejan bringing one in. It's gloved by Leighton. He'll hang on. And then Whitfield and Coburn begin to joust. We were talking with Peter Laviolette about the energy level in a game seven. You got to have it, but you also have to have the discipline and not go over the line a little bit. And the Flyers have committed two bad penalties here.
Without a doubt, what Peter Laviolette has to do with his guys is get them to reel in. So some of the emotions that have spilled out. You can't make mistakes that cost you. Scott Hartnell's was a high stick going for a puck in the neutral zone, and Danny Briere's cross-check was deep in the offensive zone. So, guys, let's go back to the game plan. Get pucks in deep, establish our forecheck, be a disciplined hockey team, and above all else, you can't take any more penalties that aren't absolutely necessary.
Weidman and Boychuk with the assist on that second Boston goal. That puck looks out of play, and it went into the safety netting without being deflected, so the faceoff out to center ice. And Weidman with his 11th assist of these playoffs, 12th point. First Bruins defenseman with that many points in one playoff year since a guy by the name of Bork back in 1991. Always good to be in his company on a list. As Hunwick send the puck ahead. Now it's dropped off for Michael Ryder. Back in the middle. Touch pass intercepted. James Van Riemsdyk the other way with it. Van Riemsdyk going to use his speed on Hunwick. Van Riemsdyk muscling in, one-handed shot. Save Rask, but nobody there for the rebound. On the other side, Van Riemsdyk a big hit on Paille, but the puck gathered by the Bruins, and Ryder turns back with it and looks for Sobotka. There's Sobotka. Couldn't center in the first try. Puck comes back to him. He's hooked. He's got away with one right there. Now Sobotka. Back out Boychuk. The shot blocked by Richards to the corner. Krajicek there. Backhanding for Asham. He drills it out to center ice. And Char will send it right back in.
You can imagine that the Bruins, with last change, home ice advantage, are really going to focus now on that matchup that has Chara against Mike Richards' line. Any other matchup that they want with a 2-0 lead. This is the number 2 ranked defensive team in the NHL. Well, they've fallen apart before, but we'll see what happens here in a game 7.
Myers trying to get their forechecking game going on this shift. Carl will keep that one in with his boot. But Richards takes it back to center. So the Flyers have to get out of the zone, and now he'll just fling one in wide of Rask. Kara is there. Ahead for Recchi. Mark Recchi, a big factor early in this series. He's been quiet the last couple games, but been a force here early in this one. He's 42 years of age, but you just had the feeling, big game like this, his 8th game 7, that he would rise to the occasion. There's Carl centering for Hartnell, but it's tipped beyond him, and now the counter rush for the Bruins. Move up with it and go wide. The shot save made by Leighton, as he's able to deny. And so, the Bruins with a good start here, courtesy of their power play. Lucic has made it 2-0.
Bruins are on top of this one 2-0 here in game 7. And if you'd like access to Flyers playoff games, just grab onto a full or a partial season ticket package. Season ticket holders, all kinds of benefits. 215-218-PUCK, or just visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.
Face off to the right of Leighton, an angle shot that Leighton is able to deny. Mark Savard. Now Savard getting the puck away from Pronger, and Lucic going to use his bulk and muscle to get it back, and he does. Dropping it off for Chetan to the point. Weidman shot. Bounces into the slot. Backhanded by Chetan. Powell didn't see it. And that one glanced wide, very near the post. Now Weidman is shot. Blocked right back to him. Shot again. Save Leighton through traffic. And Pronger will wind up and blast it. Gagne able to corral it and tips it ahead. Handled neatly by Carcillo. Carcillo will wind it blast, but a mile wide. And all the way out the other way, and Coburn will get to it.
The right idea by Dan Carcillo, everything except that mile wide part. He had Darryl Powell driving for a rebound.
Demon and MD brought down by Stewart, then Carcillo thrown to the glass. Flyers still after that puck, though. It's Timonen. Along behind the net. Giroux twisting and turning. Claude Giroux out to the point. Timonen. He'll wind. He'll fire block. Bounces almost to Richards, but a good play by Stewart to keep it away from the Flyer captain. And now Whitfield will shovel deep into the Philadelphia zone. Timonen after it, but beaten to it. Whitfield along the boards. Bodied by Richards. Back out. Thornton will drop it down low, and Braden Coburn retrieves. Bajan gets a healthy piece of in. Bruins very physical here early, especially on the forecheck. 7.5 remaining in this first period. Shots are 10-4 in favor of Boston. Coburn dropping it deep into the Boston zone. It's long for Sean Thornton. Long pass in center. Could not be handled by Paille. Longer for Carl. Game settles some now. Carl scooping that one as far as the glove of Boychuk, and then played it with his stick to Chara and ahead to Ryder. Michael Ryder to the Philadelphia line. The move on Pronger. Now behind the net as Pronger got his stick out of the midsection just in time. Back to Boychuk. Quick shots and rebound. Fanned on by Paille on the doorstep. But he gets the puck behind the net. Boy, the Bruins are getting all the loose pucks right now. Paille behind the net holding on. He'll bank it back to Boychuk for the shot. Fought off by Leighton, and it hits the post. Loose. And finally jabbed to the corner. Flyers just trying to hang on right now. Carl jabbing it along Briere. Got it out to center ice. Hartnell is there. And so is Boychuk. And Hartnell appears shaken up as he steps into the Philadelphia bench. Hunched over. Flyers get to the puck and Leno will turn with it.
Boy, if ever the Flyers could use an intermission, it's right now.
Reyes Nodelin on Ferentz. And Betts is there to help him. Betts comes away with the puck. Got it out in front. Loose puck. Bounces free back to Tiemannin. Tiemannin all the way along for Nodel. Nodel checked by Ferentz. Powell is there. Darryl Powell ridden to the wall. Lost it. Tiemannin's caught. 3-on-2 for the Bruins. Lucic with the puck. Lucic holds the shot. He scores.
Milan Lucic. Beating Leighton. It's 3-0 Boston. All Bruins here in the first.
So many times when you're trying to generate something in the offensive zone, it falls apart. Kimmo Tiemannin made a good decision to try to keep this play alive, pinching in. But Darryl Powell couldn't get the puck to him, and away came the Bruins on a 3-on-2. Excellent decision by Milan Lucic, not even to think about passing, but to take the free shot on Michael Leighton.
Well, basically what it is, a 2-on-2 right there. And you don't want to. It's a left-hand shot. He'd be telegraphing the pass. So in turn, what he's going to do is say, hey, listen, I'm one-on-one with Leighton on the left-hand shot. I'm looking for that shot, and he took it. Peter Laviolette has called timeout.
And he has the Flyers over at the bench, and obviously imparting some wisdom on them, trying to calm things down here. If they can get the next goal, try to climb back in. Hey, this series has been all about coming back from improbable deficits. They got another one right here in game 7.
Well, this situation right now is a microcosm of the whole series.
Indeed.
And the Flyers have been able to do it before.
Well, email, text, Twitter, and Facebook, 24/7, csnphilly.com is your best source for the latest news on Philly's teams. When and where you want it, be the first to know. Text alerts to 53695 or sign up for alerts at csnphilly.com. All right, timeout has been utilized. That's gone. Can't use that again. We'll see if the Flyers are able to settle down, dig into this game. 37 to play. Here in period number one. Pronger across for Richards. Richards ahead for Gagne. Gagne try to go across. That's off the stick. Spencer on to Pronger. Right now, the Bruins appear to be about a step quicker than the Flyers. Here is Recchi. That's what that confidence and adrenaline you talked about can do. Boychuk a shot. Blocked. Pronger stays with it. Tips it to Garcillo, and he just whips it all the way down. This will be icing on Philadelphia. Boychuk goes back for the touch-up.
And the reason Peter Laviolette was preaching, look, we just need one, because he knows that will level the playing field a little bit. The ice is tipped so steeply now into the Flyer zone.
Well, I just think when he calls a timeout, this guy's as good as anybody that we've seen as far as coaching is concerned, using it to absolutely its fullest. And right here, he had to make the time out right there because of the situation with the Flyers falling behind so quickly.
Less than 5 to play here in the first. Weidman across for Stewart. Stewart held into by Hartnell, but cleared the zone. Krajicek, nice play to Briere. Briere hooked a little, moves through that hook and rolls it around behind the net. Rask is checked. Good work by Hartnell. Willie Leno to the puck in the corner. Leno back to the point. Krajicek with a little room, moves to the middle and drops it back off for Leno. Leno and checked by Whitfield. Krajicek trying to continue the play in the offensive zone, but it's tipped back out to center.
The Bruins are rolling out the junkyard dog snarl.
Hunwick to it, and give them credit, Bill. This is a team that came in with all the pressure in the world on them, and they've come out and played a heck of a period so far. But rolling ahead, but Bejan is there, and he'll drill it in, takes a hop right into the blue paint. Leighton will shield that aside for Timonen, who's then thrust into the corner boards by Ryder, and again, a turnover. Svoboda centers it out in front, and that one chipped back out. Here's Ferentz at the point. He'll set it back to the corner. Haye. Svoboda. Out of the point, Ferentz holds his shot deflected. It goes wide. Again, quicker to the puck, the Bruins. Haye. Svoboda. Centers Ryder shot. Save Leighton. Asham will clear, hoping for Van Riemsdyk. It's out of his reach. He'll try to get to it deep in the zone, but Ferentz is there first. Van Riemsdyk, good hit, but the Bruins easily playing it out of the zone. And the fans here at TD Garden again letting their heroes know they appreciate their first period effort. Runger skips one in on Rask, and the angle Giroux fires one off the goaltender, but it bounces all the way out to Chetan. Looks for Savard, instead finds the Flyers, and Asham. We get to Pronger, and now Carl. Quickly ahead, Giroux for Van Riemsdyk. Now a point in this series, Van Riemsdyk trying to center. It's blocked. Around behind Richards for Giroux, and it hopped over his stick. Krejcik. Trying to get it into the corner. Weidman's there. He was careening into Richards. Richards hits the ice. Van Riemsdyk to the puck. Curl the direct shot. He scores! Dirty but good. Van Riemsdyk dribbles one home, and the Flyers are on the board. It is 3-1. James Van Riemsdyk, his first NHL playoff goal, and they like it in Philadelphia.
Well, they should. It's a huge lift for the Flyers here with only 2:48 to go in the first. Mike Richards out here on the line with Claude Giroux and James Van Riemsdyk. Van Riemsdyk has been fighting it. Look at this. I mean, ugly at this time of year, especially when you're down 3-0, is really pretty.
Well, you see the Boston Bruin defenseman, Stewart, he actually kind of slides right in front. And when he slid, I think Rask lost sight of that puck. Van Riemsdyk, he's just in the right spot at the right time to be able to take that shot. And boy, I'll tell you what, is that timely or what?
We'll see if it really gets James going, because when he's a confident player, he can be dynamic.
Well, he's already done something in this game that Peter Laviolette talked to him last night about, and that is, instead of shooting from the top to the circles, driving the net, and he tried once to drive the net. You got to know he's going to do it more.
Van Riemsdyk gives the Flyers life. Here they come.
Flyers are on the board, 3-1, the Bruins lead. Let's take a look at this late goal by James Van Riemsdyk here in the first period. Now watch Mark Stewart. This is the key, because Van Riemsdyk's going to wheel out of the corner. And when he gets this puck, he's going to go right to the net. As a result, Stewart's going to come across and try to block it. Watch the stick of Stewart. It actually breaks. When it breaks, the puck deflects between the legs of Rask, and that's what really fooled him, because he lost sight of where the puck was because it deflected off the broken stick.
Off the faceoff, a shot by Richards denied by Rask. Breer, you get that puck free. I think you're going to hear the name Richards a lot tonight. He's been playing with a lot of different partners already in this game. Bruins being out for that goal with Van Riemsdyk and Giroux. There's Blake Wheeler trying to get it down low. Timonen broke it up, but will not clear the zone. Char is there, swatting it back deep. Recky pinned. Bergeron picks up the puck. His pass tipped and made its way to center ice. Ripped right back in by Johnny Boychuk. All the way out to Bergeron. Aiden Coburn gathers for Philadelphia and finds Richards. Is he leaving the ice at all, Bill? Have you seen him on the bench?
He's hiding on the bench for 10 and 15 seconds at a time.
Giroux got the puck to Van Riemsdyk. Richards going to the bench now and is replaced by Hartnell, who got a hip check. The puck goes through as Haye moves it deep into the Philadelphia zone. Pronger will wind it up the wall, and there is Hartnell. Full board to center ice. Hartnell up the left wing with it. His pass in the middle to Van Riemsdyk. The wrist shot wide. Rebound out to Giroux for a quick shot. There was room, but Rask got the pad down and is able to pin it. That one had some room for a moment. Van Riemsdyk gets decked after the whistle.
Why, what a good decision by Giroux to take that shot, though. Underrated save by Rask.
Oh, this one was unbelievable, because Giroux's going to try to fool Rask. What he does is it's going to come from a real bad angle. But when he takes the shot, he's going to nearly sneak this one by. The puck comes right off the backboard. Look at that. Now Radisk, oh yeah, he got there. But you see where his pads were? They weren't together. That's when you really try to fool the goalie. And Giroux with a real quick shot there. And Radisk was very fortunate to get that pad right up against the pipe.
He was fortunate. He was good. He got back there quickly. And that, again, we've talked about it in this series. Big man, but he's quick.
It almost looks like he got a little piece of the James Van Riemsdyk shot in the original.
There's Stewart firing it back into the Philadelphia zone. Carl for Pronger. They're back at it. Got it past Chetan. Now the pass at Gagne. Head of the field. Couldn't hang on to it. And Rask quickly out to play it away from him. Oh, Simone Gagne. That close. Having himself a breakaway to try to get the Flyers within one. A turnover by Carl. And a shot by Savard is blocked by Pronger. 48 seconds remaining in the period. Carl starting up. At Carl, the backhand, and he'll float that one deep. Flyers making some changes as Wyden. Checked by Carcillo. Gagne to the puck. Gagne had to fire one that was blocked off by Bergeron. And now Blake Wheeler the other way. He'll pump it into the Philadelphia zone and chase with Coburn. Puck follows Coburn. He'll get it back to the team, and he has to deal with Bergeron. Starts off the check, plays it ahead. Marecki anticipates and steals. But his pass to the point is tipped out to center ice. 10 seconds remaining in the period as Charo will wind it in. Leighton knocks it down. Steven in with it. All the way ahead. Hartnell will give Boychuk one last check as the horn sounds or the siren here in Boston ending period number one. Michael Leighton saw 14 shots. Three of them got past him. Rask, he saw 8, and 1 slipped past him. 3-1, Boston through 20 minutes of play. Tonight's Flyers-Bruins first period was brought to you by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise. By McDonald's, get a small premium roast coffee for 89 cents at a medium for just $1. McDonald's, I'm loving it. And by your Quality Plus Ford dealers. Over 10,000 fans have made their way into the Wachovia Center. They've seen the first period on the big screen down there. Got to cheer once with the Flyers' goal. That goal has them back in this game at least. Here's what's coming up between periods 1 and 2. We will look over the history of trying to come from behind 0-3. We'll hear from Michael Barkan, Rick Tockett, and Al Morgani with plenty of highlights and analysis. Back with more in just a moment. This portion of Flyers Hockey on Comcast Sports that is brought to you by Chevrolet and your local Chevy dealers. 3-1 Bruins through 20 minutes. Bruins got the jump. Flyers got the last goal of the period as they try to build another comeback. And we welcome you back to the TD Garden. Bill, certainly chore here for the Flyers, but nothing new for them because they are in uncharted territory for their franchise, at least already in this series, after having trailed 3-0, making it back to a game 7. What they're trying to finish off here tonight is legendary. It's something that just doesn't happen very often. Only 3 times in the history of the 4 major professional sports, of course, football, they don't use series, but only 3 times in basketball, hockey, and baseball have teams come back from 0-3 down. There they are. The first one back in 1942. Steve Coates may very well have been at one of these games.
That ain't right what you just said there. This is back when you only had to play 2 series to win the Stanley Cup because there were only 6 teams. So that is when this happened. I don't care what decade it was or what era. It's just as difficult in the 40s as it was in the 70s when the New York Islanders did it against the Pittsburgh Penguins. The New York Islanders came close to doing it against our Flyers team well. So it was an amazing
very
run that
next
they put
series.
Together.
Yeah, amazing. And then in baseball, it's only been done once. And they tend to remember that one in these parts. The Boston Red Sox against who else but the Yankees coming from 3-0 down. A stolen base in game 4 started the whole thing. And then the Red Sox on their way to ending their long World Series drought. And they beat the Yankees that way. Incredible stories. They've all been incredible stories. And for the Flyers to complete this story, they're going to have to, come from behind.
Well, they're going to have to forget Chapter 1 of this Game 7 story because the Flyers came out
They weren't as disciplined as the Bruins. They weren't as energetic as the Bruins. The Flyers, it was almost role reversal because in games 5, 6, 4, 5, and 6, I thought the Flyers were far better prepared to play early in the games, and the Bruins kind of kept it close and came on later. Flyers are going to have to do that now because the Bruins came out juiced, jacked up, ready to go. Now that the intermission has taken place, the Flyers have a hole to dig themselves out of. But it's similar to the mentality of being down 3-0 in the series. You don't say, come on, guys, we need 3 goals. What the Flyers have to do is win the next 2 periods, then they're at least going to be tied.
Well, we'll see how they do with that. They've gotten the first step back with that goal from James Van Riemsdyk. Well, we've showed you the Wachovia Center, the bowl. Over 10,000 fans are certainly partying at the AT&T Pavilion in the Wachovia Center as well as they get ready for the second period. We'll send you back to Philadelphia after this.
First intermission in Boston. Bruins 3-1. It was Bruins 3-0 until JVR put one in. 17-12 into the first period. Rick Tockett, Al Morganti, Michael Barkant. First intermission report if you're joining us at home. Hello if you're joining us in the arena and the thousands that came in the arena. Hello as well. If you're a Flyers fan, you got to be thinking, this does not look good. I'm really concerned right now. Put our fears aside, Al.
Well, the logo for the league is history will be made. So, and if it's going to be made in this case, it's going to be made the hard way. You wouldn't think this team would do anything easy, and to get behind 3-0. And then the timeout, he's been so good with timeouts, Laviolette. So if you're looking for hope, they call a timeout, and the tables sort of turn the latter half of that, well, the very late stages of the period.
Let's talk about discipline or lack thereof. Michael Ryder gets the first power play goal off a Hartnell high stick. The second one, Lucic, power play goal off a Briere high stick. Here's the first one, Hartnell. Are these smart plays here?
Yeah, obviously it's careless with your stick, and, Mark Recchi in front with a screen, Ryder scoring. You know, these penalties are killing the Flyers, these two penalties with the sticks, especially in Game 7. What are you going to say? Like, you got to keep your stick down. Like, Danny, you can't do that. You know, you have to be disciplined. And quite frankly, they got to be more North style. I mean, the Flyers are throwing the puck too many times into the middle. But this is a great play, Lucci. Me and Al, we told him before the game, this guy was going to be a dangerous guy. He's already got 2 goals.
Yeah. That's just power hockey. And it has to, you got to put a stop to it. The Flyers have now, the Bruins have thrown their absolute best at them. For 15 minutes there, they were flawless in the way they played. And they got the advantage of those were bad penalties. And they took advantage of the bad penalties. So now you're not even on level footing. It's going to be hard to come back against them. But they should have some sort of momentum going in. It's huge to come in with that goal, that last goal.
I love Peter Laviolette. He called that timeout, as Al mentioned, and he said, one goal. That's all we need. One goal, and they ended up getting it. So we'll see what happens. We're going to send you back to Comcast Sportsnet, but if you're watching on csnphilly.com, we got a little bit more for you in this first intermission report. We'll see you in the second intermission on Comcast Sportsnet. Hang with us on the web.
TD Garden ready for second period action, Game 7 of this Eastern Conference semifinal series. Bruins with a 3-1 lead as we get started here. And the Flyers looking for that puck in center, but it's Recchi instead of an ice pass to Bergeron moving up. And this quick shot sails wide all the way out to Chara. Bodied by Tarsillo, the puck out to center ice. Boychuk has it there. Cross for Recchi, and Recchi ahead. Leighton put the paddle down and then play it to the boards. Bounces out to Richards. He'll move up with Tarsillo. Coburn trying to join the rush. Richards moves in. His shot batted away by Ryan. In the corner. Tarsillo poked it free to the line. They say it came out before Pronger fired it wide. Go offsides. Tonight's second period from TD Garden is brought to you by Acura Advance. And by Verizon Wireless. We never stop working for you. 10,000 fans, the Wachovia Center, hoping their Flyers have another comeback in them.
Right now they should be hoping that the Flyers can get the toothpaste back in the tube during the intermission, come out here and stabilize things. And look, the Bruins have a simple game plan right now. It's play mistake-free hockey. I don't care who you are, when you're pressured, you will make mistakes. The Flyers need to continue to try to pressure Boston in their end.
And if the Flyers get the next goal, Bill, who are you talking about pressure?
Van Riemsdyk, a turnaround shot to save. Nate Asham had his stick lifted in front, could not get to the rebound. But Van Riemsdyk, a nice maneuver to get that shot off. Sobotka sends in. Pronger is there. IA read it, stole it, and got it to Ryder. Ryder back to the point. Hunwick shot. The traffic deflected and went wide. Van Riemsdyk a big chop at it, and he got it down the ice, but no icing as Hunwick goes back for it.
Looks like James Van Riemsdyk is really alive now, having scored in the first period. And you, and I know I could tell, we didn't, I mean, we've talked about this almost every day. If he could just get one.
And Peter Laviolette's great at recognizing a hot player, so expect to see Van Riemsdyk out on the ice more as this game wears on.
Especially a hot player when you're down by two goals.
Nodal, Coburn on Lucic. Lucic, just great work there. Got the puck to Chetan now. To the point, shot Stewart blocked. Back out Chetan, shot blocked by Nodal. Timo Tiiminen blocked that first shot, and he's slow getting back up. Now Powell will fire one to the corner. That's his after. Around for Powell. Powell holding, try to center, blocked off. He gets it back, and he'll just send it around behind the Boston net.
That's the kind of play. It's a low percentage shot by Chetan, and when you can block a shot, come back with the odd man rush, that's the kind of play that's going to get the Flyers back into this hockey game, because the Bruins sometimes might get a little overzealous with the pressure in the offensive zone.
Hartnell takes the pass, takes the shot, and that one deflected and went wide. Briere let it go, thinking the defenseman was there, but Carl was going to the bench. So Pronger has it. Waits. Be patient.
Boy, the Bruins in a 1-4. What?
Looks like a 0-5.
Yep. That's,
and they find a seam in it as Hartnell will take the pass, move up to the corner. Get knocked to his knees, from his knees, back to Parent. He'll just dump it in along the wall. Briere is there, centering for Leno. Backhander save, rebound Hartnell. He scores! Woo! They are back. Scott Hartnell with a backhander on the rebound. Beats Rask. And this is a one-goal hockey game. It is 3-2. Philadelphia as Hartnell scores for a case of Tasty Cakes.
Well, I'll tell you what, this is patience personified at one end of the ice with the veteran Chris Pronger waiting and looking for a seam through the 1-4-D. Here it is, Pronger looking, looking and waiting. He finally picked the option that sprung Scott Hartnell loose, and everybody had a piece of this. Danny Briere outstanding when the puck went down low. Right here, quick spin around out to Billy Leno. Leno's spin around attempt. And then Hartnell with a goal scorer's finish into the top corner.
And so each member of the line of necessity, as you call it, Bill, ends up with a point on that tally. And the Flyers are within one. Gagne winds it deep into the Boston zone. Tarsila back around behind. It deflects to the corner. Richards is there. He centers. It goes off. Escape. Of Wojcik. And now darting to center is Recchi. And he'll bank it into the Philadelphia zone. Leighton stops it behind the net. He waited and turned it back over to Recchi. Recchi turning with it. Whips it across ice. Carcillo is there, and he'll slip it out to the neutral zone. And so the euphoria that existed here at the TD Garden, you can almost feel the concern now. Here's Sobotka. Sobotka back out. Stewart shot. Block chance for the Flyers to move up. Here's Asham. Asham with the puck. Carrying it up. Asham to Van Riemsdyk. Out to the line, Coburn. Coburn holding on to it, turns with it, back out, shot Giroux, and that's blocked. Now Van Riemsdyk behind the net. It got through Asham. Tiiminen lets it go, takes the hit. Giroux is there for the puck. Round. Van Riemsdyk knocks it down behind the net. Holds. Asham's in front. Van Riemsdyk with a pass for Coburn. Back around for Van Riemsdyk. Kept it alive, but Weidman then cut it off and finds Sobotka. Sobotka lobbing one, hoping for Paye. Coburn trying to come back. Paye, turn around, shot goes wide. But he missed the target. And now it's Leno ahead to Hartnell. In center for Giroux, one-on-one against Jarrow. Giroux cuts to the middle. Now looks for help. And then he'll backhand it deep. He was at the end of a shift. Hartnell goes and gets the puck. His pass off of Leno, out to the point. Carl, his pass down low. Briere whipping it off the stick of Rask and then the glass. Here's Hartnell. Turning with it on the boards. Fights off Lucic. Gets to Leno, but Leno is pinned. Looking for some help. He gets it from Hartnell. Chara barrels into him, knocks the whole pile down. Puck bounces loose. Flyers still have it. Turnaround shot, Briere blocked. Rebound controlled by Lucic. And he'll move to center, but that's it. Flyers get it back.
The hunger is back.
Wow. Remember how aggressive and how dominant the Bruins looked the first 10 minutes of this game? The Flyers have switched it around 180. And Tuukka Rask, remember the save that he made on James Van Riemsdyk, because the tying goal was on JVR's stick.
This goal, the key is right here. The turnaround by Lino, but look at Rask. Rask doesn't control the shot. He got it just trying to direct it to his left. When he directed it, guess who's there? Scott Hartnell. And to the advantage here, watch this. That's just a beautiful backhand to get it up and over into the top corner.
Pow, thrown to the corner boards, and then arriving with him was Nodal, but the Bruins move ahead. Steve Bégin flings deep and chases. He'll be the first to it. But then getting to him was Ryan Parrott. Up to the point, Weidman back around behind the Philadelphia net. Krejcik and Bégin come together. Powell with a stab at it. Bégin back to the point. Hunwick now for Bégin to Hunwick. Shot deflected by Thornton, but wide. Fourth lines for the teams out on the ice, and the Bruins fourth line spending some time in the offensive zone here. Metz leaves the puck free. His pass tipped away. Shot high and wide. Unable to fight. It was fired. Flyers need a change in a bad way here. Parent hooked. Penalty, penalty, penalty. No shot there. The hooking penalty, which led to the turnover, and the Flyers will get their first power play of the game and a chance to tie this baby up.
Boy, some great composure for Ryan Parent. He was under the gun with Savard chasing him. He was able to draw the penalty. Now the Flyers have the opportunity to tie this baby up on the power play.
I always say never try to chase a defenseman around the net. This is a perfect example. Watch this. Now this is Ryan Parent's going to pick up, and he's going to go to the other side. So what happens is Savard, he can't catch Parent. So what he does is he gets the stick right up into the stick of Parent's and then tries to drop it to avoid the hooking penalty. It didn't work.
Boston penalty.
Well, the Flyers with the power play. They're first in the game. Teaming it. Try to get that one around behind the net. Four players jammed for it. Comes free. Pronger using his reach trying to keep it in the zone. Leno at the line. Did hit Recchi. Turning with it. Leno somehow kept it in again, but now Chara has it. And he will clear. Fire power play. All right, for eight for the whole playoffs. Four for 28 in this series and only two for the last 23 against the top penalty killing unit in these playoffs. Here's Teeman in. Winds, fires, blocked. Steve Bégin felt that one as he got in the way. He's going to go to the bench as Teeman starts up. Pass glanced off Pierre Richards, and that made the play go offside as the timing was screwed up. Now Hartnell has to watch there as he and Chara started to joust, and Chara tried to draw the penalty by having his head go back, but no penalty call.
This Boston penalty kill, the whole box just moves so well together. As you see Hartnell and Chara a little pushing and shoving there, but watch this, just great block by Steve Bégin. And he looked a little bit like a goalie there. Instead of kind of laying out, he kind of wanted to put that left pad on it.
Here is Carl, dropping it off for Giroux. Giroux for Briere. This is his office. Centers for Hartnell. He had it momentarily, but could not get a shot off. And out of the other way. Need some speed as Wheeler. Coburn has plenty of speed. And shrugs him off the puck. Crowd wants a penalty. They won't get it. Here's Hartnell. Barreling to center. Drop pass Briere. Briere winds. Fires. Save. Rags. In the corner, it's Giroux. 30 seconds remaining in the power play. Giroux checked. Carl will keep it in. No, he won't. Say it came out to center and he played it back in, so offside whistle.
Boy, Danny Briere had the puck where he wanted, had the angle, wasn't a perfect angle. I think he just wanted to rip it up a little higher over Tuukka Rask. That's Danny Briere's bread and butter. Right here. Put up about halfway up the net. Danny likes to use that seven iron that he has as a stick and goes under the crossbar.
Red hot, Danny Briere. 18 points in his last 8 games, and actually with the assist here, as you saw there, 14 points now in the last 9. And he's just one of those players that rises to the occasion on playoff time. He's a point per game player in games in which his team faces elimination. That
that's saying something.
As the Bruins clear all the way down, and that will almost take care of the power play. Flyers will get a chance to start one more rush with a man advantage. Longer with it. Mark for Richards. Marines not using their speed to get there to cancel the icing. Centering pass for Gagne's. Tip Pronger there, but out of the box. Jumped Savard to disrupt him. Chara checked, but got it ahead to Savard. His pass in center ice. Daniel Paille. Paille with some speed, but lost control. Drops it back, and then Savard fans on the shot. Panarin's Dyke on it to Richards. Richards through center ice to the line. Got a weak shot off the dribbled wide. Flyers will take it. Opportunity here to make a change as the Bruins get the puck to center. Briere checked. Hartnell there. John Hartnell battling for the puck, winning the battle. Finds Briere. Briere in all the way around. He scored! It somehow got in. The Flyers have tied this game at 3. Briere just firing it from an impossible angle, and it wound up in. The Flyers, much to the happiness of the throng at the Wachovia Center, have made it all the way back to 3-3. They score for a case of Tasty Cakes.
Boy, when Danny Briere hit the blue line, it was like he was shot out of a cannon. A good defensive play there by Matt Hunwick that looked like it might have a chance to keep it out, but it went up in the air and then bounced off of Bruin and into the net. There's the play by Hunwick. It might have gone off the back of Rask or off of Andrew Ferentz, but the Flyers have tied this game.
It goes right off of the back of Hunwick and hit his stick, then his butt, and then into the net. Now watch Briere. He's just trying to stuff it. Here comes Hunwick. He gets a piece of it, then it hits his butt, and then goes over the shoulder of Rask. Rask wasn't even close. He was straight, spread right out, had no chance to be able to get that puck because it went up and over him.
And Koji, it looked like it came down, landed on the ice with a spin on it, right against the post, and then spun off the post and across the goal line.
He doesn't look amused by all the spinning and bouncing. Oh, Julian.
I wouldn't think so.
They are reviewing this. Here is the call from Kelly Sutherland. Microphone does not appear to be working.
We can read lips.
It is a goal.
Upon further review, the goal counts.
And the Midas touch of Danny Briere continues as he picks up his 7th goal of these playoffs, 5th of this series. And they've come back from 3-0 down in the series in games, and now they've come back from 3-0 down in goals here in game 7.
As soon as Danny Briere got the puck, you talked about his points per game in elimination games and in the playoffs. He's a man possessed when the puck is on his stick in the offensive zone.
He's officially now over a point a game. He's got 2 here in this one. Here is Coburn sending one wide, and now Recchi to the puck. Perhaps not ironic that Danny Briere is coming up with the big plays in this game, because he has been one Flyer who certainly has embraced the challenge of trying to come back. Have a look out here. Recchi to Wheeler, knocked down. Oh, Carcillo hit with a high stick. There's a penalty coming up here. The fans here in Boston think it's on Philadelphia. I think there's 2 penalties being called, a hook and then a high stick. I think we're going to get 2 penalty calls here, 1 on each team. Well, maybe not. Only Carcillo has gone to the box.
Well, wow. I saw a hook signified by the ref and then a high stick, so I was kind of lost on that one too, JJ.
Well, he definitely made 2 signals, but he only gave 1 penalty.
Well, he called it a high stick on Carcillo, did he not?
Yes. So a power play for the Bruins as they try to retake the lead. They've scored twice for the man advantage already. And they go right to work. Weidman, a shot deflected wide. The Flyers' problems on faceoffs is really hurting them in the penalty kill in this game, because the Bruins just go right to work. No time wasted off of every faceoff. That puck was hit with a high stick. And so a whistle.
Well, you probably don't want to miss another moment of Flyers playoff hockey, and you don't have to. You can get access to all the remaining playoff home games. Lock in your seats for next season now. Flyers representatives, they're waiting for your call at 215-218-PUCK.
Bruins again win the draw. Weidman around for Lucic, skips past him. Savard with a pass that's intercepted, but Timonen could not clear. Savard has it back. His pass to the other point, Weidman. Now for Boychuk, one-timer past Savard. He tried to redirect it, but it had too much juice on it. Lucic, written by Pronger.
and then given some trouble by Betts, but he got the puck free. Savard out to Weidman, who had it hop over his stick to center ice. And Bruins not very good on the power play through the first six, but certainly have been tonight. Lucic. Put that in. Carl. Nice play there by Giroux, tipping to Richards, who skates it out to center. Deliberately. Checked from behind by Lucic. Bats the puck back in.
Both Weidman,
in the Boston zone.
Both Weidman and Richards hit it back to one another out of midair.
42 seconds remaining in the power play. Chetan dropping it back. Weidman across Bergeron's shot right into the midsection of Layton, who hangs on.
Good read by Michael Layton. He knew where Bergeron was. He was over square and stopped when the puck arrived. Michael Layton has kind of found his game here too after allowing the first three goals of the game.
Seventh goaltender in NHL history to have his first two starts be in elimination games. One other Flyer goaltender in that list, Rob Morin, won both of his first two starts facing elimination. Chara is getting it back to the point. Block, but Ryder now keeps it in. Cross ice, Hunwick. 18 seconds on the power play. Recchi. Right for Chara. Slides it back along. Recchi knocking it out of midair to Chara. Chara spinning with it. Seconds. Kicking off the power play clock. Chara one time. Blast blocked by Carl. Betts has it. Carcillo leaving the penalty bench area as the Flyers third all the way down. So they dodge that bullet. Back to five-a-side hockey. We pass the midpoint of regulation time. Deadlocked at three. Sobotka deals it deep into Philadelphia ice. Krejcik backs him up. Now Ryder trying to maneuver off the wall with it. Briere staying with it. Krejcik ahead. Out of the reach of Briere. Played back by Stewart. Nicely to Sobotka. Sobotka hangs on. Waits. His pass all the way across. Shot. Layton makes the save. Denies Andrew Ferentz. And Hartnell then wins it off the boards and all the way down. No icing. As Rasker played.
Well, that was one of those surprises. Michael Layton might have known Andrew Ferentz was there, but he had so far to go he couldn't be set and stopped for the shot.
Blake Wheeler stopped by Matt Carl. Wojcik back for Boston. That's our 17-15 in favor of Boston. 7-3 in favor of Philadelphia here in the second period. Giroux tried to center. Went all the way through Van Riemsdyk. And Leno will both leave work. Van Riemsdyk recaptures. Finds Giroux. Giroux down low. Here's Leno. Twisting and turning behind the net. Loose stick on the ice. There's Bergeron without a stick, but he gloves the puck out to center ice. So he did the best he could. And there's the zone, but right back in Van Riemsdyk, turning away from a check. The pass in the middle to Asham, spinning. Asham got it back out in front. Penalty. Penalty coming up. Mark Recchi is not happy. So this one apparently on Boston. A Flyers power play when we return. Tied at three. Danny Briere's remarkable playoff run continues. Seven, mere mention of it brings excitement. And boy, this one's been exciting. And Danny Briere in the middle of things again, 11 times now in his career. He's tied a playoff game. And in fact, Bill, six of his seven goals in these playoffs have changed the lead in a game.
Such unbelievable for both Scott Hartnell and Danny Briere. They took penalties that were avoidable penalties in the first period that cost the Flyers goals on both of them. They've both scored and have been a part of this comeback. That's why you just keep playing, baby. Yeah,
you better believe it. This team looks out and dead. We've said that before, and they've come back to life. Wojcik is off for hooking right now. Flyers with their second power play of the game. Another attempt to take their first lead of the contest. But the Bruins clear all the way down. Chara getting plenty on that clear. Layton will drop it off for Timonen. Flyers have Gagne, Leno, and Richards up front with Timonen and Pronger manning the points. Timonen dropping it back for Richards. There's the zone. Move it along. Yep, Gagne thought the point man was there and Timonen was not, so in essence cleared the puck for the Bruins there. Now Timonen ahead to Hartnell. The Flyers are changing up front. Hartnell off for Briere. Briere in front for Giroux, and it went in on Rask. Instead, he made the save.
And Bajan will clear ahead. It bounces off of Pronger to Paille, but he couldn't do much with it. Already halfway through the man advantage. Carl ahead to Briere. Darting through center. Briere will flip it off on the right side. Nobody home, though. Stewart will play up, and Coburn was drifting. Could not get there to keep it in. Now he has to try to keep it away from Wheeler. Wheeler right on his tail. Rolling out the other side and then turned back by Whitfield. We can see why the Bruins are so good killing penalties. Dogged pursuit of the puck. Giroux spinning that one off a skate, but then played back out by Boston.
Well, we always talk about denying time and space as the best defensive mechanism. It's hard to do when you're down a man, but the Bruins do it as well as anybody I've seen all season.
Coburn dumped it in. Puck bounces out. Here's Giroux. Finds Carl. Moves in with it. Looks for Asham and deflects it in. And oh, and Rask had to get his pad down as the Bruins can see the puck go all the way down the ice. And that'll do it. Boychuk out of the box in 2 seconds. Pass ahead for Asham. Tips through. Here's Van Riemsdyk charging in. Van Riemsdyk drag shot. Batted by Rask high in the air. Lance right in front of him. They jam for it. Where is it? Rask holds his glove up. Referee hasn't made a signal yet. And the puck is covered. No goal. Wow. I don't know how it didn't go in, but Kelly Sutherland right there saying no goal. Finally gives us a signal, and the faceoff will take place deep in Boston ice. Richards wanting an explanation. We'll take a look at it, or maybe a couple looks at it when we come back.
Well, we have been sitting here reviewing all of the angles that we have of this last sequence. That was a real close call at some point. It looked like you might have been able to make the case right here. Watch the post at the bottom of your screen. Rask's left pad right there looks like it gets pushed across the line. You lose sight of the puck. By the time we pick it back up, visually, the puck is from another angle outside of the line. Here's where we lose sight of it right now, right there, and we can't tell where the puck is. Oh, my gosh, wait a minute. It did look like it bounced off Rask's left pad behind the line. Right there. Now the question is, if you looked at that angle and then looked at the overhead angle to see where Rask's pad was at this point in time, you would know whether the puck was across. But you'd have to go up to the overhead and try to sync them up. Yeah, the question is Rask's pad, well, the question is Rask's pad behind the line?
They still have to be able to see the puck. That's the problem. And there's no real good sight line there, guys, to be able to actually see the puck. We assume we know that that puck is under the pad. I agree with you totally. But they, in Toronto, are going to have to see absolute proof that the puck was across that goal line.
You see the puck with one angle, you don't with the other. Can you go by where the pad is with the other, using the other one?
It's really complicated. If you can deduce that the puck is flat against the pad on the one replay, right?
Mm-hmm.
And your replays are time-coded so that you look at the overhead one at exactly the same time, and you can see the pad behind the line. That sure looked like it was across the line there. I mean, look at his pad. You can see white under.
Oh, wow.
Another reason the NHL continues to look at technology to decide conclusively whether the puck is over the line.
The other question there, Billy, is that, and it can't be taken into consideration now, but whether Weidman actually grabbed that puck and gave it over to Rask, because then if he did grab it in the goal crease, it should have been called a penalty shot.
Yeah, well, they can't go back on that one and unring the bell, but this one they can because the play hasn't resumed yet.
Again, this is to show you a time of reference here, where it hits his pad. Yeah, you can't see the puck, but the pad's clearly behind the line.
Yes, you can see that at some point, and the thing is, you would have to time code the replays so that you saw his pad from the overhead at this point right here. Tuukka Rask is looking out front. You can see he has no idea where the puck is. It clearly bounces off his pad. From this angle, it looks as if the pad is across the goal line and behind the goal line. This is a toughie.
And, you know, there are four different networks broadcasting this game. Here's the call.
Upon video review, The puck does not completely cross the line. The call on the ice stands.
Wow. You know, not only did he say no goal based upon inconclusive evidence or anything like that, he came right out and said it never crossed the line.
Yeah, they must have tons of replays that we don't have.
Yeah.
I don't mind an explanation that we couldn't conclusively prove that it was across the line, but maybe tomorrow we can take a look at everybody else's replays.
There are four networks doing the game, and perhaps there's another look, but the bottom line is it was close. The Flyers right back to work here as Pronger. Now low, Leno. Leno pushes the puck free. Briere holding on. Backhander! Save Rask! Again, they jam forward, and Rask holds the fort. Danny Briere so slick around the net once again. Well, we've already, and we still have 4:59 to go at the second period, had a lot to break down with this game, and that process will certainly take place on Flyers Post Game Live. Michael Barkan, Rick Tockett, Al Morganti, Steve Coates, cast of thousands going over this game. The best Flyers Post Game crew on television as they'll break this game down. Exclusive player interviews and reactions, press conferences, all of it immediately after the game here on Comcast Sportsnet. Puck is set all the way down. Race for the icing touch up, and Carl got his stick in there. Beautiful job by Carl getting it around the big body of Lucic to get the whistle.
Well, the crowd didn't like that one, but Pierre Rasico, one of the better lines in the National Hockey League, he does a great job there of being right there as Matt Carl beat Lucic the length of the ice. That's just great hustle by Matt Carl. That's the kind of thing, total effort at both ends of the ice, that wins hockey games, and that's why the Flyers have come back from being down three.
Pretty well know you're going to get your body pressed by Lucic too at some point on that play, so Matt Carl gave up his safety to make sure that that was an icing.
4 minutes, 40 seconds remaining, period number two. Carl starts up. He was thinking about a home run pass attempt for Giroux, hesitated, lost it, and now this. Recchi centering. And Carl got back to tie up Bergeron in front, but Bergeron out of the puck behind the net. Twisting and turning and flinging it out to Wheeler. Fakes the shot, gives it across. Weidman shot, save, and then Gagne bunted it out of harm's way. Wheeler trying to get it back to the point. Giroux intercepted, but the Bruins back to the puck. Recchi knocked down. No penalty. Tried to draw one. Didn't get it. Weidman flipping one. That's blocked by Gagne. Simone still getting in the way of shots.
Unbelievable.
As the puck rolls out to center back in, Bruins would have been offside, so the Flyers get control. Here's Giroux looking for and finding Richards. Richards snaps the puck deep into the Boston zone. Leno will chase. Leno checked. Lucic over there. Leno digging away, looking for some help. Didn't really get it that time. It was one on three, and the Bruins clear. Coburn across for Thiemannin. Thiemannin float one deep. His Ferentz for Weidman. Ahead to Savard. Good breakout by the Bruins. They gain the neutral zone with speed. Lucic jams it deep. Leighton is there. With the help of Coburn, got it to the corner. Briere took a hit, played it past Chara and down the ice. Wojcik hustling back to beat Hartnell there. A reverse to Chara. Chara now for Chetan. Chetan couldn't get it past Powell at the red line. And they say Coburn was still in the zone, and so that's ruled an offside. Earlier, leading all players in this series, coming in with 26 hits. He had seven more hits than any other player in this series, so he's been physical. That is his MO. He's out with Ashen and Van Riemsdyk, with Giroux spending time in the power play and also getting some shifts on first and second lines. Centering pass here, but it's batted away by Sobotka, and he has it. Full head of steam to the Philadelphia blue line until he runs into Chris Pronger.
Squash.
End of that head of steam right there.
Chris Blatt.
Here's Ryder. Long. Paye couldn't knock it down. Krajicek. Oh! Takes a hit from Sobotka, but moved it ahead. Took the hit to make the play. And now Powell will bounce one to the left of Rask. Stewart is there. Flyers trying to make a change. Bruins trying to take advantage. Sobotka moves up. Shuffles it deep for Paye. Paye bumped by Coburn. It's the Ryder. Ryder Close to the wall by Richards, who comes away with the puck, got slashed, and his stick goes flying out of his hand, but no penalty. Asham will just backhand it. And the neutral zone, Weideman has it back in. Check, put the puck to Bergeron. Bergeron, the backhand centering. Gagne blocked it. Bounces free. Wheeler to it. Wheeler's pass out into the slot. Weideman shot save. Layton boxes around in front off of Thiemann and back out to Chara. Loose stick of Richards still sitting just to the right of Layton. Behind the goal line.
And the Flyers were playing shorthanded for 15 seconds while Mike Richards went to the bench to get another stick.
Recky centering pass denied by Asham as Chara went down the back door. Now Chara sneaks it free in front, but nobody home. Wheeler for Recky. Pressure from the Bruins. Recky knocked down by Thiemann. Bergeron in deep to get the puck back for Boston, but then Asham steals and bounces one all the way down the ice.
Interesting sequence with that lost Mike Richards stick. At one point, Mark Recchi scooted it out in front of the net in front of Michael Layton, and then Zdeno Chara pushed it back in front of Layton. They wanted to keep it there, and it's still there.
It is in the slot. Now Briere knocks it out of the slot as Hartnell gets the puck. The other object of the player's attention out there, it moves it through center.
Scott Hartnell dropped his glove and was just frantically motioning at the bench for somebody to give him a glove, but that couldn't happen that fast.
Now Shatan to Lucic, winds up, and his shot deflected by Carl out of play.
Well, what do you think? Is this action any good? Would you like to get close to the action with the lower level season ticket package? Now's the time. You can score the best seats, great season ticket holder benefits. Just call 215-218-PUCK or visit PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. The lower level seats at the Wachovia Center are great when the Flyers are in town. They're also great when the Flyers are out of town, such as a game like this, and we're pumping the game back on the big board.
They have to be enjoying this Flyers microcosm, this game of the series thus far. And as with the series, we just don't know who's going to get that fourth goal, as we don't know who's going to get that fourth win in this series. 38 and a half seconds remaining in this second period. Another Flyer that's playing in some pain.
Just a gutsy performance by Blair Betts. He went off clutching his right shoulder in game six. Came back in the third period, but didn't come back to the ice. Came back to the bench. He's here in uniform. What a game for the Flyers tonight. You can't even make the case that the Flyers weathered the storm that the Bruins threw at them in the first. They fell behind 3-0. When James Van Riemsdyk scored to make it 3-1, then the intermission happened, and that's when the Flyers were able to gather themselves. So, second period, completely different game than the first period.
And also the timeout, Bill, at 3-0, you called the timeout. And you were able to get that goal from Van Riemsdyk. Offside called it. I think, furthering your analogy, I think the storm blew them down. They've been able to get back up.
And Coach, you mentioned earlier about Peter Laviolette calling timeouts, and it's, you know, he goes on a gut reaction. He didn't need any kind of gut feeling in the first period. He just had to look up at the scoreboard and see 3-0.
Yeah, that was enough of a reason. And so, his team responds. 3-3, 19.6 seconds remaining on the second period clock is Boychuk finds Shatan. Shatan moving on up to the backhand. Save Layton. Marked that one down, although he got some help keeping Shatan to the outside. Centering pass by Bergeron deflected and makes its way out to center. Boychuk on it there. Takes a hit from Hartnell as he delivers the puck back into the Philadelphia zone. Hartnell and Boychuk have some words as the siren sounds. Period number two is history. The Flyers get the only two goals here in the second, beating Rask twice, and they have tied this game remarkably at 3-3 through 40 minutes of play. Tonight's Flyers Bruins second period was brought to you by Suzuki and the amazing Kizashi Sport Sedan. And by Metro PCS, now $40 for unlimited talk, text, and web. Taxes and fees included. Here's what's coming up between periods two and three. Michael Barkan, Al Morganti, Rick Tockett back in the studios. They'll have their analysis. We'll break this one down, but right now let's go downstairs as Coatsy chats with the captain.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. And I would imagine you were over discussing that no goal that was, it pretty well could tell that the puck had crossed the line, but there was no video evidence of it.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of goes both ways. You probably don't want him to call that if it goes in our net, and I mean, that's the rule. We got to live by it. We got to move on.
3-0. then 3-1. What was said between the first and second period? Because that was just one whale of a second period you guys just put on.
Yeah, we played well. JVR did a good job in the first there to get us going, get us on the board, and give us some confidence. But he's played a terrific game thus far right now, and we're just kind of building off of him.
Richie, thanks very much.
Thanks, Coach.
Back up to you, Jimmy.
Mike Richards, who has led the way for his team in these playoffs. Tied at 3. Headed back to the guys in Philadelphia after this.
There have been some great games, some memorable games in the history of this storied franchise. And if the Flyers can manage to win this game, you could put this one right here that you're watching right up there with all of them. There's the pavilion at the Wachovia Center. Hello, as we are rocking in Boston and certainly in Philadelphia as the fans at the Wachovia Center are enjoying themselves as if it were a game on home ice. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. We don't want to talk about Sunday. As we welcome you to the second intermission report, Rick Tocchet, Al Morgani, Michael Barkan. They score two unanswered goals, 2:49 in the second period to get the first one. They're one down. We're thinking, well, what are the chances they can tie this up? Have you ever seen anything like this?
No, you are watching an immediate classic.
An immediate classic.
This is an immediate classic, what's gone on. With the way that they've done this talk, it's been difficult. Guys that made mistakes in the first period came back in the second period, big goals.
Great play by Pronger, patience. Hartnell cuts across. Boston doesn't get it out here. And this is great. Just get the puck behind the net. The Flyers have capitalized by this and get the puck in the net. It's a great play by Hartnell. But the Flyers seem to be getting the puck behind the net. Maybe people out of that said something in between periods. Let's get the puck behind. But that's a great play by Pronger. Patience in the neutral zone. Get the puck behind the net. Back to the point, and Hartnell goes to the net. And this is where Scott Hartnell's important, is he goes A to B player, get to the net, and it's a hell of a backhand now.
Go to the net.
Here's the tying goal.
And Briere has just been an absolute monster, coming around, throwing the puck up there. Again, traffic in front, getting the goaltender going across the crease, follow around, try to swing around, just throw it there. Look at this. It's unbelievable. And those were two guys that in the first period took the penalties, and we saw Briere in the previous series make a mistake, come back and score a big goal. It's absolutely unbelievable. Unbelievable right now what this team is doing to get behind in a series, behind in a game, and just have obstacles are no obstacle. It's just beautiful. Go forward.
One period. Well, maybe more. You don't know. And we know what Bundy said. He said he thought all these games were going to go into overtime. And how about Michael Layton stopping all six shots he faced in the second period? We're on CSNPhilly.com right now, and we'll see you post-game.
Bruins got the first three. Flyers have the last three as we're between periods two and three of this one. You look at the breakdown of this game seven situation. 14th for the Flyers. They're 7-6. Their last one was the win over the Capitals in overtime 2 years ago. The Bruins 9-9 have lost their last three. And home teams, yeah, they've been okay through history, but not so hot in these playoffs. But
the three game sevens have been won by the road team. Montreal won two on the road, and the Detroit Red Wings won in Phoenix. So recent history favors the Flyers. It didn't look like it was going to smile on them in the first period, did it?
It did not. Flyers fell behind by three, and then head coach Peter Laviolette called the timeout.
Not only that, he called everybody in because he really wanted them to listen to him. And one of the things he said is, we need one. James Van Riemsdyk got it started, and that stabilized. Scott Hartnell, a central figure in this game, and Danny Briere as well. They both took penalties in the first period. They cost the Flyers goals. They both scored to make sure that they went from zeros back to heroes again. And the Flyers are going into a 20-minute, possibly longer, but right now, if it ends in regulation, a 20-minute hockey game tied 0-0 to start.
Yeah, I mean, they were down three games to none. All they really have to do is win a period, and they make history. And James Van Riemsdyk certainly part of that as he got things started with a goal. Now, there's some controversy here because the Flyers nearly had the lead. And our angle here, we thought, showed that the puck may have gone across the line, Bill, but maybe not conclusively.
Well, we looked and we looked. The question is the pad behind the line? And this is the wrong perspective to make that call, but I mentioned this during the game. This is one of the reasons the NHL continues to look at different alternatives, technology-wise, to determine whether pucks cross the line, and they have to do it. There are too many close calls that I think are inconclusive. Some are in, some aren't. But something will be done by the NHL, and sooner, I hope, better than later.
The official announcement, by the way, is that after looking at several different angles, they determined the puck did not completely cross the goal line. And so this game remains tied at 3. Danny Briere, a big part of the Flyers' comeback in this series and in this game. Back with more in a moment. And welcome back. We're going to show you some of the great moments from this season for the Flyers. A great season it has been, as we try to thank the people who made these broadcasts possible, starting with our crew, our executive producer and director Brian Cooper, associate producer Chris Kajal, graphics coordinator Kyle Graber, and all the wonderful people, both home and road, who helped bring you these broadcasts. We certainly could not do it without them. Also like to thank the entire Flyers organization, Peter Luko, Shaw Tilgeron down, the PR staff, Zach Hill, Joseph Villebrock, has been doing great work for us all year long. And of course the players, plenty of cooperation from them. And the fans, you the viewers, we thank you. It's been a wild, sometimes rocky ride, but boy, it has been fun, and it continues to be fun here tonight. They are rocking at the AT&T Pavilion. Third period action around the corner. Back in Boston, third period is underway. Either team wins this period, they win the series and move on to the Eastern Conference Finals. To host, by the way, as the puck is deflected on out. Nato Char is there, takes a heavy hit from Carcillo as he clears it into the Philadelphia zone. Tevenin is there for Coburn. Coburn will backhand along through Carcillo and out to center ice.
Perhaps we should say it, the next team that wins a period will move on, whatever period it is.
Indeed. That's us. All with our great crew here from the TD Garden in Boston. Will history be made on this night? The Flyers try to complete a spectacular comeback in this series. They've already made a spectacular comeback here in this game. Rask will handle the puck. Tied after two. Where are your records? Puck moved ahead to Ryder. Bruins have been an outstanding third period team in these playoffs. They've scored a goal in all but one of the games in these playoffs in the third period. And that was game five of this series. Winding around behind, out of the reach of Fire. Weidman pinches and swatted at. Caught up in sticks and skates along the board. The boards, I should say, and it comes free, but Drew could not catch up to it. Now it's Pronger.
The battles would have to be won, though, especially in the defensive zone. And you can't get out-supported. I mean, if the Flyer is grappling with a Bruin along the boards, watch to see what color that third jersey is arriving.
Really all about timing, too. There's Betts. Trying to supply some of that timing to Nodal here, but the Bruins still move the puck ahead. Big hit! Lucic knocked down by Coburn, and now Powell to the puck. Powell is hit by Boychuk as he slips the puck deep into the Boston zone. Nodal after it behind the net. Lucic able to jab it away from him. To Chatan ahead to Savard. And Savard will play it into the Philadelphia zone. Layton dropping it off for Coburn. Long outlet hoping for Briere, but getting instead Andrew Ferentz. His pass into the skates of Chatan, who flings it as far as Kyle. Maybe the linesman actually getting in the way of that. And now it's Chara. Into across the Philadelphia line and up it in. Understand Earl Kyle is headed towards the Philadelphia locker room. We'll try to get a report. Chara in from the point. It's the puck behind for Trent Whitfield, but Pronger battling with Chara. The two towers of power right there, and Pronger won the battle and got the puck out of the zone. We can at least look Chara eye to chin. Most of them it's eye to chest. Moving on in, Leno's shot is blocked. There's Ryan ahead. And a nice pass into the middle by Bejan to Recchi. Recchi holding on and then firing it wide. There's Ryan gets to it, banks it, hoping for Recchi, but out of his reach. Stewart is there. Down behind. Bergeron trying to set her. Krejcik and Coburn, your defense pair. Leno going with Recchi, but Recchi won that battle. Weidman bounces one. Coburn and Bergeron behind the net. And there's the good support from Blake Wheeler. He's then wrestled to the boards by Leno. Wheeler trying to get away from Leno in that big body of his. Wheeler banking it back to Weidman. All the way across. Stewart forced by Richards, who sent him toward the boards. Coburn wrapped up with Bergeron. The puck back out to Stewart for a shot. And I believe
save. Leighton did get a piece of that after a redirection to keep it out. Now Bergeron to Weidman. Weidman centers. Loose puck, diving shot. Wheeler save. Leighton. And now Richards. Flyers need a clear here, and he will scoop it to the neutral zone. Flyers have some tired bodies out on the ice. They're making the change, though, as Stewart carries it back in. Backhander goes wide. Out the other way, Paille. Paille around behind the net. Pronger couldn't get to it. Sobotka in the slot. Shot. Ryder glanced off the post. Chara sent it around behind. Bruins with the pressure here. Giroux could not clear. Chara shot blocked in front by Pronger. Tanya leaned on from behind but got the puck out to Giroux. And now it's Asham tipping into the Boston zone. Flyers need to spend more time down here. And here's a great steal by Giroux. Giroux around behind. Centers it in front. Unable to get the shot. Was Van Riemsdyk. Back to Krejcik. Krejcik for Asham. Winds and fires. Blocked. Bounces wide. Giroux. Now the surge belongs to Philadelphia. Tiemannin to Giroux. Giroux trying to get to the high slot. He's knocked down. Still flings to the corner boards. Chara leaning on Van Riemsdyk. Asham is in the puck. Squirts to Krejcik. Back along for Van Riemsdyk. And now Asham behind the net. Center. Loose puck, Ryder tips, Van Riemsdyk gets it back. Van Riemsdyk centering, Giroux shot goes wide. Barron's trying to tie him up, but Giroux still got a shot off. Now Asham, back for Giroux, and it's the Bruins finally getting control, but they're the team on their heels right now, and Chara will clear the zone. Krejcik cuts it off at the red line, but the Bruins are getting their much-needed change.
It's unbelievable playoff hockey, unbelievable.
Is that a great effort by your third line to boot?
Rask able to cover as that puck is bounced in on him. Tonight's third period on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you by the Pennsylvania Lottery. Benefits older Pennsylvanians every day. Must be 18 or older to play. Please play responsibly. And by Mazda. Take a test drive at your Mazda dealer today. Zoom, zoom, wherever.
Flyers have been hanging in there. 50% on the faceoffs through two periods. Oh,
Chris Pronger. One off the post. The light goes on behind Rask, but no goal is the ruling. Right off the draw, the howitzer from Pronger nearly gave the Flyers the lead. And at least one goal judge thought it did give the Flyers the lead. Oh, Powell wipes out going back for this puck. It's up, and there's Betts to help him out. There are Betts. Sailing that one out to center off of a couple of gloves. Just about 6 minutes in, third period. Here come the Bruins now. Chetan to Bergeron, behind the back, pass it to the side. Lucic there, knocking it down, but the Flyers stay with him. They keep it away from him. Here's Powell the other way. And he'll just send it through the neutral zone. Enough drama for you, Bill?
Plenty.
Here's Weidman.
Thank you.
Couldn't get it past Leno. He bunts it ahead to Hartnell. Hartnell cutting in. Wide fire is deflected by Stewart. Out of play. We'll step aside, catch our breaths. Pronger shot redirected and off the inside of the post. It stayed out barely.
What do they say? Keep your head up when you're looking for that puck. Well, look, Milan Lucic is going to get caught with his head down, and Braden Coburn is going to take a perfect shot right at him inside the blue line, and that's why that's our Wachovia great check of tonight's game.
It's a tough guy. Knock off kilter like that. Coburn looking on. Here's this Chris Pronger drive, Bill. Great redirection by Powell.
Well, Darryl Powell deflected it right there. He also won the faceoff for Blair Betts. He's the guy Powell was that got it back to Pronger in the first place.
Well, back to live action now as Chara goes back to get the puck in his own zone. The boy Chuck, big swing at it. Got it ahead to Recchi. Mark Recchi. Deliberately through center, finds Chara. Now Wheeler is stopped by Carcillo. Gagne jumping on the puck. A forward back in the 3-on-2. Gagne to Richards. Richards, the shot, save Rask, and the rebound. Bounces all the way out to Tiemannin. Now keep it in. Tiemannin finds Carcillo. Carcillo angle drive, and that one deflected just out of the reach of Gagne. Now the Bruins with a chance in transition on a 3-on-2. Here's Recchi looking for Wheeler. It's deflected away by Pronger. Wow, what a play that was, because Wheeler was lurking.
Braden Coburn did a good job of getting back after he stepped up and was caught on the play.
Has those wheels. Here is Pronger now. Settling things. Starting up.
Crowd trying to be enthusiastic, but you can sense the tension as Pronger drills one in from center. Stewart ahead. Ryder couldn't come up with that. As Coburn thumped in, and this will be icing on Boston. Coburn very physical here in this third period. Coming up tonight on Sports Night, highlights of the Phillies game in Milwaukee. Exclusive coverage of this unbelievable hockey game in Boston. Analysis and interviews. Get all the news Philly fans need to know on Toyota Sports Night tonight at 10 on Comcast Sports.
Well, some guys might be fading energy-wise. Braden Coburn of the Flyers is stepping it up physically.
Be able to see this game again. You saw those encore presentations. It's certainly going to be worth another look, or two or three, as Paille slides the puck into the Philadelphia zone.
The Flyers going with five defensemen, so you're seeing all kinds of pairings out there. It's Krejcik and Kiemann right now.
This will be icing on Philadelphia unless they get to the puck. Leno does not. So the faceoff all the way back into Philadelphia.
Mentioned earlier, the Flyers are hanging in there. 50% of the faceoffs through two periods. Patrice Bergeron is the ace for the Bruins. He is taking half of their draws. He's not out there now. It's Mark Savard. And he will go against Danny Briere of the Flyers.
And the Flyers gain control. It's Hartnell ahead for Leno. Leno will chip and chase. We'll get to it. And then Chara gets to him, knocks him to the ice. Hard to escape. Zdeno Chara. Now it is Lucic. Two on the night. Charging on up. Stops. There's the backhanded in, and Pronger says, no, sir. Flyers have it here, but they're running into Pronger. Now they can't find the puck. It is Giroux who somehow does and maneuvers it ahead to Leno, and he'll slip it into the zone. He's a magician with that puck in traffic.
Got a magnetic puck and a metal stick. It's all working for Giroux.
Steal by Asham. Asham around behind. Wraparound try. Save Rask. Wojcik is there. He maneuvers through some traffic and headmans to Sobotka. Sobotka right wing feed. Japan will just slide that one deep. And Ringstein takes the hit, protects the puck. Let's play it up, but Weidman's waiting for it. And he tried to drill it deep, and it went off the stick and up and out of play. Weidman's been logging a lot of ice time.
He has, so is Claude Giroux.
Well, certainly this game has taken on the personality of the series. 3-0 up, 3-3. 3-0 down, 3-3. Absolutely unbelievable how close this has been.
Flyers again, just by sheer hunger, control a draw as Nodal outworked the Bruins for the disc. Got it to Powell, and he'll backhand it in. Nodal would work along the boards, but then finally did. Loses balance and go down. Paille. Down for Andrew Ferentz. Ed Sobotka. Sobotka's had a rough run in these playoffs, but score a goal here, you can become the hero. That's all forgotten. Coburn. Long outlet for Powell. He and Bergeron come together. Bergeron got the worst of it, and Betts stuffs it into the Boston zone.
One of those times where Darryl Powell looked around to make sure he knew what was coming at him.
Ryder, laterally in center. Ooh, really too many men on the ice for the Bruins there. Little call, and now Carl back to get it from Philadelphia. Got it past Bergeron. Gagne had trouble, but right there is Carl. He has been so solid in this series. Passes it through center, teaming in with the read in center. They joust. Finally, it is Bergeron to the line. Finally worked it through. Here's Recchi. Just fear this guy. Such a big game player. Back out it goes Chara. Shot blocked off by Recchi. One hands it ahead. Chara used his reach to keep it in momentarily, but now it's out to center. We pass the midpoint of this third period. Still tied as the drama builds. Recchi backhanding it. Over to Kara Wheeler in front. Carl wanted a penalty. Again, they won't get it. Carl waiting, and he'll just send it through center off Weidman's stick, and Chara is there. New center. Gathered by Coburn. Braden Coburn. Lost it. Look out. Here's Lucic. Moving up. Lucic checked. And Coburn comes back to poke it to the corner. Set around the boards. Weidman there. Tried to drop it back and did, but now Hartman uses his glove to knock it down and charges up. The right wing feed to Briere. Flyers have a 2-on-1. Briere looking for Hartnell. It's tipped away as the Bruins got back in a hurry. Flyers with a slow change. Here come the Bruins. Lucic. The shot. Hit the post. It appeared to change direction. It was a knuckler, and it then hit the post.
Post at both ends now here in the third. Now Leno the other way. Leno, stick handling, centering. That's cut off by Savard. And now play stopped. I'm not quite sure why play is stopped. The linesman referee converging. And I think a penalty. Will tell you about it when we come back.
The Flyers are going on the power play. The Bruins guilty of too many men on the ice. And it was clear cut as well. We'll play connect the dots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Bruins. Not even close. Easy call for the linesman to make. Went over to the ref and said there were 6 in black. What an opportunity for the Flyers.
They're a little sensitive here in Boston some 31 years later to too many men on the ice penalties in game 7s. Had one against the Canadians, you remember, on Cherry. Canadians went on to score and went on to the finals. The Stanley Cup. Here's Hartnell. They get that puck in front. Paille there, but Hartnell takes it back. He's been a mountain in this game. Just such a force ever since. Unfortunate incident in the first couple shifts. Here's Pronger. Briere dropping it down low. Giroux. Flyers are set up. Giroux back to Pronger. No shooting lane, gives to Giroux. Giroux to Briere. Briere turning out with it. Fans on the pass, lost control, gets it back, keeps it in the zone, looks to get some space again. Flips it for Giroux, but he couldn't come up with it. Now Tiedemann in from the point. He jabbed it free. Boychuk's going to try to reverse it, and he will with authority all the way down.
Now the Flyers are going to have to change. That was a lot of energy expended, and they weren't able to generate a scoring opportunity.
The Flyers a little indecision here in their own zone now. Carroll jabbing at it. Coburn to Leno, but up in his midsection. Bergeron to it. Look out. Here's Bergeron in. Finding Recchi. Recchi banking it back. Stewart shot. Blocked. Carroll got in the way of it. Coburn has it. He's going to try to skate it up this time. He's being harassed. So the one hand to Leno. Leno continues to rush it across the line. Drops it to Gagne. Gagne feathers it down low. Weidman after it. Coburn in deep. It bounces to Richards, who swats at it. Leno chips to Gagne. Gagne looking for an open man. Carroll at the point, 26 seconds on the power play. Now it's Gagne. Gagne for Leno. Leno to Richards. Richards' shot redirected. Gagne shot. He scores! Simone Gagne! Can you believe it? Power play goal, and the Flyers all the way back now lead this thing 4-3. Gagne continuing his remarkable comeback from injury. He scores for a case of tasty cakes. The Flyers with 7:08 to play have the lead.
Oh, magnificent poise. Gagne with it to Leno. Leno knew what he wanted to do, and that was get it out to the side to Mike Richards. Richards with a nice little feather touch pass in front, and then the poise really took over. Gagne got it on a broken play, turned and ripped it off the post high. Unbelievable play.
Great time to be a left-handed shot. All by himself. Rask tries to come out to cut down the angle, but because he's got a left-hand shot, he goes top shelf far corner.
Simone Gagne is hardly 100%, folks. He is playing in a lot of pain. Unbelievable. Flyers looking for more power shot. Rask the save. So the Flyers with 6:50 to play. Have the lead for the first time in the game. There is Betts turning it back around. Lucic is there. TD Garden suddenly very quiet.
I'll tell you, we had a remarkable 3-minute sequence with Braden Coburn. He was on the power play. In his own end, in the offensive zone, he almost never got off the ice. He just about willed the Flyers to that goal.
And Riemsdyk chops it out to center ice. Now the Flyers want to protect the lead, but you don't want to sit back too much. Van Riemsdyk breaking up that pass in center, but Ferentz jumps on it. Hit across the line, and wide it fires, save late into the corner. Ferentz back after, rubbed out by Coburn. Carl for Van Riemsdyk, fluttered it. Getting a hand on it with Sabotka, but he's overrun by the Flyers. Asham ahead to Van Riemsdyk, charging into the Boston zone. And then a good play made by Ferentz to poke it away from him. Paille bumped. Sabotka to the puck. Sabotka to the Philadelphia line, one hands it deep. Richards is back. Sabotka takes it to the boards, but great support. Tiedemann for Gagne, he's checked by Weidman. Still, able to kick that puck. Kick his stick to play the puck down the ice. Now Richards trying to get back. No icing. It died before the goal line. Big hit on the boards on Bejan by Carcillo.
Sobotka gets to it, 5:25 to play here in the third. Sobotka. Got it as far as Pronger. Cross ice for Carl. Carl in no hurry. Has a look. And gives to Pronger. Pronger didn't get that past Wheeler. Breaks up the pass coming back toward the Philadelphia line. And now it's Leno trying to get that through to Hartnell. And he does. And Hartnell will play it into the Boston zone. Chara is back. Now the Bruins feeling the weight of history on their shoulders and backs right now because they need a goal or else they're going to be an object of history they did not want to become. Flyers now have the lead. Gagne with the power play tally. We'll be back.
Well, that's the crowd. It's back in Philadelphia at the Wachovia Center. And obviously, they're very excited about what's happening here. Remember we had talked about taking timeouts? How Peter Laviolette knows what to do and what time to take that timeout? Well, it was 3-0 at that time. And then after that, not one, not two, not three, but four consecutive goals for the Philadelphia Flyers, who now lead this one 4-3, 4:46 remaining on the goal on the power play by Simone Gagne.
Mark Recchi moving it back. A timeout becomes a turning point in this all-important Game 7. There's Thiemannin ahead. Giroux for Richards. He'll bank it into the Boston zone. Kochuk is back. Richards gets a piece of him. Giroux to Gagne. His turnaround shot is blocked. And now it's moved ahead, and here's Chara. Chara fouling his own dumping. Back behind the net, but right there is Pronger to send it up the wall and down the ice. Weidman trying to get away from Betts. Is it to Lucic, and now Weidman again. Matt Hunwick winds it into the Philadelphia zone. Leighton will stop the puck for Pronger. Ahead it goes to the point. Weidman, look out. Cross ice now in the slot shot. Steve Leighton. Leighton with the huge stop to preserve the lead as he was able to rob Savard. Carl to the puck. Hits the referee. Lucic to the puck. Lucic around behind. Carl comes back to poke it to the corner. Lucic is there again. Betts now reaching for it. Every scramble for a puck. Desperation written all over.
There's the support. Matt Carl making sure that he outnumbered the Bruin in the corner.
And a bad bounce off to Stanchion, but who's there but Andreas Nodal to recover the puck and clear it into the Boston zone.
Flyers want to be aggressive here. They don't want to just sit back and let the Bruins come. That said, you've got to make sure you've got at least three guys back at all times.
This will be icing if Thiemannin can get there. They say he didn't get there first. So play carries on. Hartnell buried from behind by Stewart, but Briere has the puck to Leno. Briere then gets dumped. Here's Leno. Stops, holding on, all the way across to Briere. Two Flyers in the zone, four for the Bruins. So they'll just chip it deep. 2:50 remaining in the third. Ryder. Across. Ferentz. Moves it up. From the red line, sends it in. Ryder. And Carl. Carl jabbing it to Hartnell. No, couldn't get it through. Ryder the steal. Ryder to the back end. The shot blocked. Hartnell sliding across. Made up for the turnover by blocking the shot. And now it's Richards poking it through center ice around Boychuk. Richards turns with it. He holds. He takes a look. His shot goes off a stick and wide. Fighting to get to it. Giroux now for Gagne. Another shot. Stick save Rask. Gagne's got it again. Hobbled but not slow. Here's Giroux. Giroux ridden by Boychuk. Giroux outworking the Bruins. Three of them working on him, and Giroux continues to control with his skates. What work by Claude Giroux. Finally taken down. Just continues. He gets back up to control the puck. Time wasting off the clock as Claude Giroux, one-man game, finally just backhands.
Unbelievable. The Claude Giroux show is officially on stage. That ate up 20 seconds off the clock.
1:40 remaining. Flyers with a steal. Hartnell will play it deep into the Boston zone. They have to try to get Rask to the bench in favor of the extra attacker soon. Sobotka. Toward center. Chips it. Carl reaches back, gets to it, plays the center. Chara plays it in, but there are Bruins already in the zone. Flyers have time here to move up. Hartnell will flutter one. And then Betts will knock it down. The Bruins get to it. 1:12 on the clock.
Chetan sends it in. Rask is heading toward the Boston bench. Extra attacker is now on for the Bruins. Sobotka behind the net. Sobotka. Check. Recky in there. Powell after it. Lucic cuts it off. The shot blocked by Pronger. Now it's Recky. Jabbing at it. Goes off his stick and into the safety netting. Play stop. 53 seconds between the Flyers and some serious NHL history.
You can pretty well expect the Bruins to call a timeout. The Flyers used theirs back in the first period. One of the best spent timeouts I've ever seen by Peter Laviolette. The Bruins here with 53 seconds to go. Don't have much of a choice. Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
And the team's gathering by their benches, so it's obvious that, quote, Juliet has indeed utilized his timeout. And this gives the Flyers players time to rest just as much as it gives the Bruins time to organize.
Sure. And look, you can draw up a play on your chalkboard over there, but depending on what happens with the faceoff, I mean, it's out the window right away. Peter Laviolette is making sure that everybody knows their coverage depending on what happens in the faceoff. And if the Flyers win the faceoff into the corner, you can pretty well ensure that there's going to be a blasted hard rim around to the weak side. Peter Laviolette's letting his guys know what to do if the Bruins win the faceoff, and the folks in Philadelphia at the Wachovia Center are revved up.
As they should be. Bruins fans here in Boston just hoping against hope that their team can come up with something in the final 53 seconds.
Claude Giroux here on the draw. Mark Savard for the Bruins.
And Savard won it cleanly. Back to Weidman. Bergeron, Setterin goes off the stick, and it stayed in play high off the glass. Back out to Chara. Chara across. Weidman's shot goes wide. And kept in, they say, by Chara. 37 seconds. Tiemannin pushes it to the quarter board. Pushed back along. The battle is on. Savard got it to Lucic. Lucic is checked. Chance to clear for Richards. He got it out to center ice. 22 seconds. Weidman across. Savard will blast it in. Leighton could not stop it. It went off his skate. Played by Recky to Lucic. Now Bergeron. 12 seconds. Bergeron centering. Comes back out. Chara turning with it. 8 seconds. He'll wind it. Fire wide. Weidman back to it. 5 seconds. Turns. Flips. Blocked off. Giroux will clear the zone. This improbable, incredible comeback is complete. History made in Boston tonight. The Flyers defeat the Bruins 4-3. They are the third team in NHL history to come from behind after trailing a series 3-0. Celebrate, Philadelphia. You deserve it.
I have been around this game more years than I can remember. I have never seen anything like what the Flyers have accomplished here. Never seen it. Not only in the series, but in this hockey game. They were dead in the water in the first period. Well, we've come to learn there's not such a thing as a Flyers team, at least not this year's team, being dead in the water. Unbelievable.
Michael Leighton becomes the goaltending hero. But you just, Bill, we'll find out when this playoff run is over, and who knows when that's going to be, the way this team is going. There are a lot of guys that are so banged up for this team, including the guy who gets the game winner, Simone Gagné. And I mean, it's just, again, if you wrote this script for Hollywood, they toss it back at you and say, that's too hokey. It really,
really.
And now they shake hands. The Bruins have to be stunned. Only the third team in NHL history to cough up a 3-0 series lead. But this was more about the Flyers going and getting it than the Bruins coughing it up. I mean, the Flyers, it's just so resilient.
In this game especially. In this game especially. It's a lot of work just to get home ice advantage in the next round, huh? Go
How
figure.
About that? 7-8 in the conference finals. First time that has ever happened. Flyers versus Canadiens. Simone Gagné, one of many heroes, and certainly another one is Chris Pronger, and Coetzee is with him.
Thanks very much, Jimmy. I don't even know where to start. I've never seen anything like that before. I said that it kind of resembled the whole series. You go down 3-0, you come fighting back. But have you ever been involved in a comeback like that?
I don't know about in a game 7. That was unbelievable. Obviously, Leitz needed to shut the door after that horrendous first period we had. Reimer getting that goal with 3 minutes to go was huge for us. Gave us a little bit of life, and like I said, we got some timely goals from a lot of different guys.
Every time this team had its back to the wall, it just bounces. It doesn't just come back, it bounces. What is so special about this group of guys?
Well, I think our ability to just continue to believe, but also stick to the game plan, whether we're down 3-1 or up 3-1. We got that fourth goal to go up 4-3, and we didn't just sit back. We learned from our mistakes, and relentless pressure all over the ice. They really couldn't get into our end very much. Obviously, at the end, guys are diving all over the place, trying to block everything that's going towards the net, so it was awesome.
Chris Pronger, congratulations, Jess, and your teammates. Fabulous, just absolutely fabulous.
Thanks, Coach.
Jimmy, back up to you.
His seventh game seven is a winning one. Our Bud Light player of the game is Simone Gagné. Broken toe, came back, and his return, maybe the turning point of the series, Bill, because he came back, Krejci was gone, and that seemed to swing everything.
Well, I think we consider that Gagné would supply an emotional boost for the team, but he supplied instant offense, which was so needed.
And Claude Giroux certainly supplied some thrills, especially that keep-away game, Coatsy, there late in the third period.
That was the old Quebec keep-away at the end there. They had three guys trying to get the puck off you, but what a great job of just holding on the puck in the corner. And that was just indicative of a whole team effort tonight.
Yeah, the guys really worked hard. I think when we were down 3-0, the way we played in the first period, that's not our game, and we weren't too happy about ourselves. So, came in a third and second and third, and we played the way we wanted.
You know, when you did have that puck, you did the classic thing of keeping the puck between you and your opponents by using your body. And boy, I'll tell you what, they didn't know what to do. They didn't want to take the chance of taking a penalty, but you just kept on holding on the puck.
I was trying to waste time there, and I was able to keep it as long as I could, and I was pretty tired at the end, but the guys really wanted this game, and we really worked hard, and we're ready to go for it against Montreal.
All right, Claude Giroux, thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Jimmy.
All right, Coatsy. The Flyers now one of four teams in professional sports history to come back after trailing in a series 3-0. They join the 42 Maple Leafs, 75 Islanders, and the 2004 Boston Red Sox. Hail to the Flyers. Tonight's Flyers Bruins Game 7 was brought to you by your local Chevy dealers. By Bud Light, the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. By Wachovia, the official financial services partner of the Philadelphia Flyers. And by your local Tri-State Toyota dealers. Go Flyers, go Toyota. Toyota, moving forward. All right, I have a hard time believing I'm saying this, but get ready for the Eastern Conference Finals opening up in Philadelphia, folks, on Sunday night. Flyers and Canadiens, tickets are available. Representatives are standing by right now. You do not want to miss it. The Flyers, 4 wins away from going to the Stanley Cup Finals. Canadiens will be a heck of an opponent. They've just knocked off the Caps and the Penguins. But hey, Flyers have shown they can pretty much overcome any obstacle this particular year. So the Flyers win it 4-3. They complete their magical comeback in this series and move on in the Stanley Cup playoffs. For the entire crew, as well as my partners, Bill Clement and Steve Coates, I'm Jim Jackson. Good night from the TD Garden, but stay tuned for Flyers Post Game Live presented by McDonald's, a complete recap and lots to talk about. History made in Boston on this night.